Devotees in India who had followed Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission for generations and generations and generations, their whole lives. They're wonderful devotees. But as far as Mahaprabhu's prediction, his will to spread Krishna consciousness in every town and village, so much. But by Srila Prabhupada's desire, by his love and compassion for all living beings, he came here to America. And just people who had no conception of real religion, spirituality, what to speak of Gaudiya Vaishnavism, within a matter of months, he transformed them into empowered preachers performing work that was literally historical. And we've been hearing about it. How many people in Mayapur, Vrindavan, chanting Hare Krishna, are willing to face the Hell's Angels? Without the slightest bit of fear. We heard from Bhagavanta Prabhu how Jayapataka Swami Maharaj. This is so much Srila Prabhupada's legacy. How he inspired and empowered those who loved him. Atlanta is one of the great examples of this. And how Srila Prabhupada encouraged each and every devotee. I remember a few years ago I was listening to a tape recording of an arrival address of Srila Prabhupada in Atlanta. And I don't remember the exact details, please forgive me, but what I remember. Srila Prabhupada said, I have been on tour, and I was in Caracas, and I was in Mexico, and I was in Miami, and he said so many other places, and he said, now I am in Atlanta, and of all temples, this is the best. And then he came to New Orleans sometime after that. And he said, of all temples, this is the best. And he said that he would come and finish my palace and I will stay there and live and translate all my books.
Wow.
And we weren't thinking so nice. But then later I heard he said that so many places. It's not that he was just trying to encourage. He just had such potency to inspire, encourage devotees. And like Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was dancing in 7 parties in Ratha Yatra, and every party was thinking he's only with us.
Yes.
Actually, he was only with them. And there was a beautiful story where Lord Chaitanya was dancing with his devotees around the Jagannath Temple in Puri, just before Ratha Yatra, and they were at the back entrance. And all the devotees were gathered around Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There were hundreds and hundreds and hundreds. And each one, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami explains, each one was thinking that Lord Chaitanya is only looking at me.
Uh-huh.
And then Srila Prabhupada gives example of the cowherd boys on the bank of the Yamuna when there'd be thousands and thousands of gopas having prasad with Krishna. Everyone is thinking Krishna's only looking at me. So Srila Prabhupada had that compassion to make each temple, each devotee feel so important and so critical to his mission. And his love empowered devotees who are sitting here today to give up all of their material promising careers, wonderful families, to live in a place where there's no door in the bathroom. People walking by every second. Nuclear up and we never had a door.
Did you have a bathroom?
Go down the hill. So why would Americans from middle class, upper middle class families live like that? And risk their lives and be ridiculed and persecuted, and like my dear God sister was talking about, be put in jail. And never consider that I should be doing something else. That was Prabhupada's compassion, just empowering the devotees. And I have to agree with Srila Prabhupada that of all temples, Atlanta is the best. Raghunath Das Goswami, under the order of Sri Nityananda Prabhu, serving all the Vaishnavas and all the townspeople and everyone else with those 2 pots of chipped rice, half were soaked in condensed milk and half in dahi or yogurt. And he worked so hard to make this wonderful, wonderful festival. And after, first Nityananda Prabhu had him serve all the devotees and show compassion to all the fallen souls. And after doing that, really being the servant of the servant of the servant, then Raghunath Das Goswami approached Nityananda Prabhu and said, no one can approach Lord Chaitanya directly. That everyone knows. We must approach through you. So please, grant me your mercy that I can be liberated from material life and take shelter of the service of Lord Chaitanya. And Nityananda Prabhu had all the devotees present bless Raghunath Das Goswami. And after he received all those blessings, he placed his lotus feet in Raghunath Das Goswami's head and said, yes, you will soon escape from your material life and you will be personal associate of Lord Chaitanya under his personal secretary, Swarup Kamadhar Goswami. That's the culmination, the essence of this beautiful pastime. And similarly for us, we could only approach Lord Chaitanya through his most empowered, through Lord Nityananda Prabhu's most empowered representative, his divine grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami. His mercy, his love, his encouragement, his example is all that we're made out of. I didn't want to speak, I was just so happy listening to my God brothers, but somehow all of them dragged me into that. I was with His Holiness Jayaprataka Swami Maharaj mixing the ingredients for about an hour in the kitchen.
Thank you.
And I was thinking that His Holiness Jayaprataka Swami Maharaj, how he has so beautifully imbibed Sri Prabhupada's spirit to encourage devotees, traveling here, there, and everywhere to encourage the devotees. I can tell so many stories of what I've seen since he's had his stroke. He's come all the way here just to encourage the devotees. And I was thinking, because I'm so mixed up, by nature I'm such a mixed up person, and he wanted to dovetail my propensity by mixing up the children. That was Prabhupada's expertise also, to engage us according to whoever we are, but encourage everyone to feel that we were really a vital, important devotee in his heart and in Lord Chaitanya's mission. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So that concludes our Srila Prabhupada Lila Smaranam for this year. I'm sorry. And I just wanted to make a final comment, because we began our discussion this year more or less encouraging all of you who might not have met Prabhupada or seen Prabhupada in any way other than through his books and through his disciples and so on and so forth, that you should embrace this part of the festival. This is a very, very important part of the festival. And I remember some years we'd have just 2 or 3 devotees, 5, 10 devotees, 15, 20 devotees, but look at this room. Look at how many devotees are here, sitting here listening about Srila Prabhupada during the festival. So we're humbly requesting that all of you embrace this part of the festival very, very sincerely, because as I said earlier, you know, at least physical, in the physical body, we will not be here in the future. Those devotees who were here when Prabhupada came to Atlanta. So to keep this mood going of glorifying Prabhupada during Panihati Festival is going to fall upon you. So we thank Ananda Vishprabhu for speaking so nicely about his experiences of becoming Krishna conscious through Prabhupada's books and the other various devotees who have spoken. And of course, to be blessed by His Holiness Radha Swami at this party is just so wonderful. And I just wanted to say that this has been the longest Srila Prabhupada Lila Smaranam that we've ever done. And everyone seems so fresh and still excited to hear. And we could go on more, but I believe the RT is coming very soon. We're waiting for Tuck Marsh to come back, right? Unless, because we want to keep this mood going, unless there are some other comments, especially from second generation devotees, you look at them like you're ready.